My question is, do you generally not recommend mixing ecosystems in the stack like Microsoft Teams and then adding Google Sites and Workspace? Yeah, good question. You basically want to pick an ecosystem, whether you're using Google or whether you're using Microsoft, you're probably going to pick one of those and just stick with it. Google gives you some pretty cool, say, backdoor options in that if you are using the Google ecosystem, Google Workspace, you can still use all of your Microsoft format documents. So you can still use them in Google Drive. You can edit them in Google Drive for free, which is pretty cool. You're not going to have all of the features of Word and Excel, but you pretty much got just about everything you need to get work done. If you like using the local, you know, experience of Word or Excel, you may choose to use the Google Workspace as an ecosystem for your mail and your contacts and your calendars and your meetings and, you know, all the other cool things that it includes, like classrooms and sites. But then just pay for a Office 365 subscription just for Word and Excel. Some businesses do that. And so they kind of stay in the Google ecosystem, but still do a bit of Microsofty stuff. And you can, of course, drop your Microsoft documents into Google Drive and have them backed up and synchronized between devices and whatnot. I would ask why, when Google format documents have a lot of amazing collaborative features and, you know, pretty much have ticked every box in terms of feature parity for what you get. But for some people, they just like the Microsoft way, and that's totally okay as well if you want to run both. I would recommend you choose one ecosystem and you stick with that. There is something else that I want to mention though on choosing software, and I've got a video on my YouTube channel specifically about how to make great technology choices, so you know what my framework is for actually choosing pieces of technology in your business, and I list down all of the different criteria that you should use for choosing great business software and making great decisions. Is when you've got all of these different apps and solutions here, you're typically going to find in your industry that you either have one do-it-all app, or you're going to have to like piecemeal together a hodgepodge of different applications to make your business work. And that's usually, you know, the balance. You're going to have one trying to do it all app that probably doesn't have every single feature that you need. But then on the other side of the coin, you're going to find, you know, a selection of best practice tools that you try and get together, talking to each other and syncing together. I don't think there will ever be a perfect app for any business or for any industry. And if you think about the option number three, which is to develop your own app and try and make it perfect, well, the downside of that is that you have all of the additional overhead of actually managing and launching and maintaining and developing your own custom application, which is my strong recommendation that you stay the hell away from if you're a small business owner. And so it's really a matter of, you know, trying to find something that's 80% or 90% good and making up the slack with automations. And so we use an app called Zapier.com, which you may have heard of. Zapier is basically an automation tool that allows you to connect all the different cloud apps within your business. So whether that's having a, you know, a web form filled out on your website automatically going into a, you know, like a Google Sheet, or if it's, you know, when someone is added to my sales system as an opportunity, automatically add them to my MailChimp mailing list so they can get future newsletters. All of those apps talking to each other and getting them all connected and automated, we use Zapier for that. And that's also one of the supported apps inside our concierge program. And so you can just send a message to our team. They're basically technical VAs that are trained in Workspace, Copper, Hiver, Zapier, and all of these apps and tools that make a small business work. And you can send them tasks and say, hey, when someone fills out this form on my website, I want it to automatically go into this Google spreadsheet. Or hey, can you build me a Google dashboard that takes my Google Analytics data and my sales data and, you know, works out a conversion rate based on a calculation of those two numbers? Or can you take my sales targets and actually, you know, put my zero numbers of my actual sales to date for the quarter against what my total opportunity pipeline is in my Copper CRM? They're all the kind of things that we can do. If you're a larger, more mature business and you want to get into KPIs and dashboards, they're the kind of things that our team can build out for you custom. So hopefully that answer was helpful for you. If you like this content, please hit subscribe and hit the bell notification so you can be notified when we go live or drop new content on the channel. Now, if you'd like to connect with us, hit us up on social media or join our free community group. All the links to that are right below this video. If you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and the technology ecosystem, you can join our free Genius Academy by transferring your billing across to IT Genius, or you can join a Workspace Basics Bootcamp. Now, if you're a business owner and you're interested in an audit on your technology stack or your Workspace account, or you're looking to do a project in the tech world, well, you can take advantage of our free consultation. And if you need help right now, then consider joining Concierge or taking up a quick fix with our team for professional support for your tech stack.